Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvenni. I am happy to meet you in the video lecture on the subject Fluid Mechanics and Machines. We are going to discuss about the impact of jet. This is lecture number 11.1. 11th chapter, Impact of Jet, first lecture. And the topic for this lecture, so we are going to study the impact of jet on fixed and moving blades or vanes. We recap from the earlier lecture, we studied the fundamentals of fluid kinematics and fluid dynamics. The concepts of fluid kinematics and fluid dynamics is applicable here to calculate the force of the jet and the work done by the jet on the fixed or the moving vanes. The learning outcome for this lecture, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to calculate the work done by the jet on the fixed and the moving vanes. Impact of jet. A jet of fluid emerging from a nozzle possesses kinetic energy. If the jet strikes an obstruction placed in its path, it will exert a force on the obstruction called hydrodynamic force. So we may experience this impact of jet just by opening the water tap at our home. You put your hand on the path of the water jet, you may feel some force on your hand. So the force is called as hydrodynamic force. It is due to the water jet strikes on the hand. And we are going to study the impact of jet under different headings. Force exerted by fluid jet on stationary flat plate. Force exerted by the fluid jet on moving flat plate. Force exerted by the fluid jet on stationary curved plates. And force exerted by fluid jet on moving curved plate. So we develop one by one so that the discussion or the calculation will be very close to the hydrodynamic machines, which we will be discussing in the coming lectures. So we will be discussing about the centrifugal pump and the hydraulic turbine. The basic calculation for work done in the case of centrifugal pump and the hydraulic turbine, the basic theory is from the impact of jet with a curved plate, so moving curved plate. The various assumptions for the discussion on the impact of jets. The plate is smooth and the frictional losses between the jet and the plate may be neglected. So the surface of the plate is highly polished, there is no frictional losses. There is no energy loss in the flow. So the jet is directly hitting on the plate and the work is done. There is no loss of energy. The difference in elevation is neglected. So the change in the potential energy is neglected. So we calculate the work done only based on the kinetic energy of the jet. So, first case, the force exerted by a fluid jet on stationary flat plate. So, look at the water jet of diameter D, which is moving with a velocity V in the horizontal direction, and there is an obstruction vertical plate. So, the plate is normal to the perpendicular to the jet direction and it is stationary, it is not moving. So, the water which is striking on the plate, it is getting deflected on both sides and flowing with a velocity V. Now, the force exerted by the jet on the plate in the direction of the jet. So, F is the rate of change of momentum in the direction of the jet. So, the F equal to rate of change of momentum equal to mass flow rate of the fluid into change in velocity. So, the mass flow rate of the fluid is rho A into V. So, rho is the density of the fluid, A is the cross-sectional area of the jet, and V is the velocity of the jet into change in velocity. So the velocity, initial velocity is V and final velocity equal to 0. The plate is not moving, so the final velocity is equal to 0. The force equal to rho A V square. So the force hitting experienced by the plate is equal to rho A into V square. When the plate is inclined at an angle theta to the jet, so look at the same type of arrangement. We have a jet of diameter D and the jet is moving with a velocity V which is striking the plate. Now, the plate is inclined by the angle theta. So, now the as the plate actually it is hitting with an angle theta here, and it has got two components. One is Fx and Fy. So Fx is the horizontal component of the force, and Fy is the vertical component, and F is the force normal to the plate. So F is the force which is normal to the plate. Now the force exerted by the jet on the plate in the direction normal to the plate, again the formula is F equal to mass flow rate into change in velocity. So rho AV is the mass flow rate, and the change in velocity, so V sin theta is the velocity normal to the plate, initial velocity, and final velocity equal to 0. So rho A V square into sin theta is the force which is striking, experienced by the stationary plate. So the force can be resolved in two components, one in the direction of the jet Fx, and another perpendicular to the direction of the flow Fy. So Fx is the direction of the jet, Fy is the perpendicular to the direction of the flow of water. So Fx equal to F sin theta, which is rho A V square into sin square theta, and Fy equal to F cos theta, which is rho A V square sin theta into cos theta. So F we already calculated, rho A V square sin theta. Next case, the force exerted by the fluid jet on moving flat plate. Now the plate is moving with the velocity u. So the same configuration, we have a jet of diameter d, and the jet velocity is v, and the jet is striking on the plate, vertical plate, which is perpendicular to the direction of the jet, and now the plate is moving with the velocity u. Now v is the velocity of the jet, u is the velocity of the plate, a is the cross-sectional area of the jet. The jet strikes the plate at a relative velocity v minus u. So because the plate is also moving, so the relative velocity is v minus small u, capital V minus small u. Capital V is the velocity of the jet, and the small u is the velocity of the plate. Now for the plate, when the plate is normal to the jet, so the mass of water striking the plate equal to a density into area of the jet into velocity with which jet is striking on the plate. So the rho A, rho is the density, A is the area of the jet, and velocity with which the jet strikes the plate, which is V minus u. Then the force exerted by the jet on the moving plate, F equal to mass of water striking per second change in velocity, change in the relative velocity. So F is the force, so which is rho A V is the mass of the water striking per second, and change in relative velocity, initial relative velocity is capital V minus u, and final relative velocity is 0. So the force equal to rho A into V minus u square, V minus u whole square. The work done per second on the jet, that is force into change in the distance, so rho A into velocity V, capital V minus small, so capital V minus u whole square into u. U is the change in the distance. So the work done equal to rho A V minus u whole square into u in watts. So this equation is important for calculating the work done on the work done by the jet on the moving plate. And similarly, the plate is inclined with an angle at an angle theta to the jet. So the same configuration once again, d is the diameter of the jet, v is the velocity of the jet, water in the jet, and u is the velocity of the inclined plate. The plate is inclined with an angle theta. So v is the velocity of the jet, u is the velocity of the plate, a is the cross-sectional area of the jet, and theta is the angle between the jet and the plate. So the mass of the water striking on the plate, which is again density into area of the jet into velocity with which the jet strikes the plate, the same calculation, rho into a into v minus u. So v minus u is the relative velocity between the jet and the plate. And the force exerted by the jet on the moving plate, so F equal to mass of the water striking per second into change in velocity. So which is rho A capital V minus small, so capital V minus u into the initial velocity, initial relative velocity in the direction of the jet, normal to the plate. So V minus u into sin theta minus final velocity is 0. So rho A into V minus u whole square into sin theta. And this force can be resolved in two directions. Fx is the horizontal direction, Fy is the perpendicular direction. Fx is the along the direction of along the flow direction, and Fy is the perpendicular to the flow direction. So Fx equal to F sin theta. So rho A into V minus u whole square into sin square theta, and Fi equal to F cos theta, which is rho A into V minus V whole square into sin theta cos theta. Now, the work done per second by the jet on the plate, Fx into distance moved by the plate in the x direction, which is rho A into V minus V whole square into sin square theta into u. So, the work done equal to rho A into V minus U whole square into U into sin square theta. So, this equation is required for calculating the work done per second or the power of the plate, power of the plate. And next topic is the force exerted by the fluid jet on the stationary curved plate. So, the plate is curved, but it is stationary, it is not moving. So, look at the configuration. The jet is of diameter D and with velocity V. It is striking on the curved plate. The angle of the curved plate is 2 theta. So, with respect to the direction, with respect to the horizontal axis, so theta is the angle on both sides. So, the plate is symmetrical. Symmetrical about the center or axis of the jet. So, the water hits at the center of the plate and getting deflected on both sides, and it is flowing with a velocity V on both sides. Now, the component of velocity in the direction of the jet Vx equal to minus V cos theta, and the component of velocity perpendicular to the jet direction Vy equal to V sin theta. So, the force exerted by the jet in the direction of the jet, so that is equal to Fx, the Fx equal to mass per second into Vx1 minus Vx2. So, Vx1 is the initial velocity of the jet, so that is equal to V, and the Vx2 is the final velocity of the jet in the direction of the jet equal to minus V cos theta. So, in the horizontal x direction. So, Fx equal to rho AV, mass equal to rho AV into initial velocity V minus plus V cos theta, because the Vx2 equal to minus V cos theta, so it becomes V plus V cos theta. So, Fx equal to rho AV square into 1 plus cos theta. So, theta is the angle of the jet deflected by the curved plate. And the force exerted by the jet in the perpendicular direction, Fy equal to mass per second into Vy1 minus Vy2. So, Vy1 equal to 0. Initially, there is no vertical component of the velocity before it is striking the plate. So, Vy1 equal to 0 and Vy2 equal to V sin theta. So, substituting Fy equal to rho AV into 0 minus V sin theta, which is minus rho A V square into sin theta. So, the negative direction implies that the force is acting in the downward direction. So, negative sign or negative direction, that indicates that the force is acting in the downward direction. And the jet, next topic, the jet strikes the curved plate at one end and when the plate is symmetrical. So, the plate is symmetrical. So, about the center of the plate, the angle is theta on both sides. So, the plate is symmetrical. Now, the jet is entering on the bottom of the plate and it is flowing in the direction of the plate and leaves on the other side. So, this is actually entering here. So, this is the closer to the real-time turbo machines, real-time turbine or the pump. So, the fluid enters on one side of the blade. And it is deflected by the blade and it is flowing in the opposite other side of the plate. So, this is inlet tip of the jet and it is outlet tip of the jet and the angle is theta here. Now, we calculate various parameters. Force exerted by the jet in the direction of the jet is Fx, which is mass per second into Vx1 minus Vx2. So, Vx1 equal to the jet velocity. Initial velocity in the direction of the jet equal to V cos theta and Vx2 equal to final velocity in the direction of the jet equal to minus V cos theta. So, Fx equal to rho AV, mass equal to rho A into V. So, rho is the density, A is the cross-sectional area of the jet and V is the velocity of the jet into V cos theta plus V cos theta. So, this equal to 2 rho AV square cos theta. This is the Fx is the force in the direction of the jet. Similarly, the force exerted by the jet in the perpendicular direction Fy, that is equal to mass into Vy1 minus Vy2. So, Vy1 initial velocity in the direction of the jet equal to V sin theta and final velocity is also equal to V sin theta and this becomes 0. So, Fy is become 0. So, Fy equal to rho AV, mass equal to rho AV into both VY1 and VY2 they are equal, so the FY equal to 0. So we stop here. So we discuss, we continue the lecture the impact object in the next lecture. So there are many books available on mechanical engineering subject. Here you may find fluid mechanics and machinery, which will be useful for further information on this topic. And I have a YouTube channel where I upload the video lectures on the subjects mentioned here, also the video lectures on the gate solution, gate question paper solution. So you may subscribe and use the video lectures for your better learning and passing the gate examination. So thank you for watching. You please post your comments and subscribe the channel, and you can write to my mail ID for further information, or WhatsApp number for further clarification on the subject. We'll meet again in the next lecture. We continue the impact object in the next lecture.